Mr. Serizawa, start your engines!
What is up, guys? Today's Awesome here. Welcome back to a brand new video. Welcome back to Road to Rosie Boa. This is episode 5, I believe. I'm not feeling too great. I don't know. I got some weird, like, headache coming on. And my stomach's been weird, but we're going to power through it. So we have an unboxing video, and I'm pretty sure this is just going to be it for this episode. Because I got nothing else really I want to do. I don't feel good. And also, today's video is supposed to be unboxing for this. But you know what? I'm going to hold off. On the side of the tank, big nasty crack. I think you can actually probably see it from here. If it will focus, it's not fucking focusing. I don't fucking care. I don't want to fight with the lighting. But yeah. But I said some harsh things in that unboxing video. And honestly, I don't know if I want to spill bad blood just yet. So we're going to hold off. It may not be uploaded. It may not see the time of day. It just really depends on a lot of factors right now. So we have this unboxing video from, I don't remember who it was from, Reptilian Arts. And I can say right now, the box is beat up, but I can tell you, there's bubble wrap inside. So way better than the packaging I got in that. Anyway, and there's a lot of fragile stuff. I doubt what's in here is actually fragile, but you guys remember from last episode, I did order some hides, and that's what we're going to be taking a look at today, is some hides. And first up, okay, the box is a little beat up, but that's okay, because this is for the reptile and not for me. This is the primitive skull. I think this is actually perfect size for my little Rosie Boa, and it's going to look really sick in the tank, and I'm getting a cool-ass background, so that should be a lot of fun. We'll take him out. That's fine. You just do you, Bo. Next is a really simple one. Actually, this is kind of big. I should have got the small one, but this will go into her 20-gallon enclosure when she's bigger. But this is just a basic, you know, medium hide box. Again, this is from Reptilian Arts, and so far they did a wonderful job packaging this. And last but certainly not least, we have the crocodile skull, which is super, super badass. And it's actually pretty decent size. So once again, should be perfect for a little Rosie Boa. And maybe the teeth and the texture of the actual crocodile should actually be beneficial for shedding. I think all of this really should. So, all right, let's just get him out of the box and take a closer look at him. All right, got him out of the tie wraps. That's just the box. Cool. All right. It's trash though. So here is the actual skull. Now, I'm looking at this. It's pretty decently weighed. Just wondering if there's anywhere where it is unsafe for the actual boa. And I'm thinking this piece right here actually might be too sharp. But I don't think she's going to be sticking her head in there, but you never know, really. I'm just kind of hoping that she just uses these holes and the eye sockets for entries and exits and not really so much these or underneath it. I just might chip this away if I can or sand it. So it's not incredibly sharp, but it's a little concerning. I don't like it. I don't think that should even be there. I think this should be a hole. Even if this is part of the actual of an actual crocodile skull, for safety reasons, it shouldn't be there. So I kind of don't like that already. And everything else looks cool. Just gotta wash it. Just wash everything before you put it in your enclosure. That is 101. All right, let's take a look at the primitive skull. All right, yeah. So that's it. Very desert-esque. So that's garbage. coverage. And this is really cool. This looks a lot safer. Just that is really, just really concerning to me. But, you know, Mozart, to be or not to be, that is the question. Milk cow. Pretty decently weighed. Entry way in here. Should be fine. Don't feel like it's sharp enough. Just might be, you know. This could aid in shedding. She's small enough to go through the eye sockets right now, but I'm wondering if she can get too big for them. And if not, I don't know. Might have to get rid of this or seal the eyes shut. But I don't know. They're like really cool side by side though. Should add some, you know, aesthetic to the aquarium. And then there's this guy. That should be perfect. Overall, they're pretty cool. I got some concerns regarding, you know, some areas, but overall, I think it should be fine. I think these are primarily used for lizards, but I did see that a lot of people use them for their ball pythons. This should be really, really cool. Trying to think what else. I'm not very enthusiastic today. Yesterday, when I got that thing and see that it's completely damaged, that kind of knocked the spirits out of me. And today, I just don't really feel good. So, I'm trying to be enthusiastic as possible. One thing that should have been in this unboxing video is actually the rodents that I bought from Big Cheese Rodent Factory. Because they have like a cool ass map when you order from them, it tells you like when you should expect your shipment to be shipped and when it should be expected to deliver. It should have been today, but I got zero tracking information from FedEx, which is really funny because FedEx sucks. And that enclosure behind me was broken by FedEx. And technically the sender as well. Because if you don't properly package something and something gets damaged in transit, it's both parties' fault. The motherfucker who should have been handling it properly, and the motherfucker that I should have suspected the guy wasn't going to handle it properly and should have packaged it properly. But that's none of my business. So, I think that will do it for this episode, guys. Unless, by some miracle of a chance, FedEx just pulls up with my rodents. But I fucking doubt it. And when I get those rodents, I expect them to be thawed out. Because they're fucking bitches. And as always, stay awesome. In my mind, worlds collide, and something inside me is gone. But still I keep holding on. In my mind, oceans divide and I don't know where I belong, but still I keep going on and on. I get by in a world with no conscience.